20 years ago, one man's death here on Palm Island became a defining moment in race relations in Australia.
Emotions have been running high on Palm Island, and today anger over an Aboriginal death in custody boiled over.
In November 2004, Cameron Mulrunji Doomadgee, a popular 36-year-old father, was arrested by a white policeman, Chris Hurley, who claimed Cameron had been swearing and charged him with being a public nuisance. 45 minutes later, Cameron Mulrunji Doomadgee was dead in a police cell from severe internal injuries, which were later compared in court to those of a plane crash victim. The community wanted answers, but police kept quiet. 100 of Cameron's friends and family gathered to hear the autopsy results read out. Their grief and frustration grew into a riot. The Queensland government declared Palm Island a state of emergency, and riot police were flown in. Senior Sergeant Chris Hurley was eventually acquitted of manslaughter.
I rang the police station. One sergeant answered, and then he handed me over to Hurley. And Hurley said, "Oh, who are you?" I told him my name. He said, "What relationship are you to the prisoner?" I said, "That's my brother." And then there was a long silence, and then said he couldn't talk to anyone at the moment, and they hung up. I didn't know how he died. And then I found out through that, and I just broke down. When we had to go to the legal case, it was like a circus. We didn't know where we stood. We thought we won at one case and then got dropped again. And when he got acquitted, that just tore us away. We didn't know what to do. We thought the police were there to protect us, you know, and bring out the culprit. How do you accept an apology from the government after you lost a life? I couldn't accept it. Is that story was going to bring my brother back? Because that's all we wanted. My brother was a hunter, very kind and gentle, and share everything. Made a lot of friends. Hardly got in trouble with anything, police, anybody else. Yeah, he was a good father. He's a godfather to my children. Well, when you see Cameron, you'll see me behind him, you know. I'm always following him. And all my friends were his friends, and his friends were my friends, so miss him so much, eh? When I do miss him, I talk to my daughters. We all have a good laugh, you know, about memories. Because he was comical, you know, really larrikin. Always make everybody laugh. He was my rock. I just want to keep his memory alive. Well, I was born here, and my family are buried here, but I won't leave now. I think that's what's holding me here. Like, I wouldn't want it any other way, but yeah, I feel more comfortable here, knowing that they're here.